Ko boš povej, Captain Blush.
Whatever you want.
Well, do you see the red light? Salute quick.
Oh.
Yo.
Salute to all viewers and subscribers.
Yes, yes.
Yes, welcome to the channel where we don't edit nothing because...
Yeah.
We are...
Who cares, eh?
Who cares about this? Yeah. Who cares about editing, eh?
I mean, hey, I will tell you this, my friends.
That time that we would edit, we would rather go flying, eh?
Yeah, when we will start to edit on this channel, we will close this channel, and that's the point, eh? But, of course, I will salute, and you will salute, every pilots and friends who are filming this amazing hobby, and they edit. Salute the editors, because to edit the video, that takes time and brains, and I don't know what. But we are rather... Just filming and that's it. We use that time to fly something and unbox.
So, what do we have here today? Well, just when we have done the unboxing, we said that we're going to do the assembly video.
And now we have this.
And as we all know, with the E-Flite planes, it cannot get much easier than this.
And that is why we're filming this. Because if this would take us...
If I would have to assemble the boss plane, well, we would have to charge the camera 150 times.
Eh? Yeah.
Because I usually assemble boss planes, I don't know, for 2 weeks every afternoon.
Well, that means that then we would have... I mean, we are not filming that just because we would have to edit. But maybe in the future, Captain Blush, we will also film when you will assemble the balsa plane, but it will be in a few videos, not just in one.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe we can do that.
Maybe.
Yeah. So this is it, Captain Blush.
Meanwhile, we will... So, what do we need? We will assemble this.
Yeah, what will you be assembling even today? The air tractor.
An air tractor from E-Flite, 1.5 meter wingspan. But actually, when I was looking at the manual, there is only two pages. First,
and the second,
and here it stops, eh?
Yeah.
So, you'll only need...
Yeah, because we can see here that you have only two bags of screws, and that's it.
These are for the wheels, this is for...
The wings, now this is for the wheels.
For the wheels, yes.
For the wheels, for the wings, and you are done.
What I will be using, I'll be using Phillips screwdrivers, needle nose pliers, this is just for backup, and... This is
well, mostly you will use the screwdriver and that's it.
Yes, and,
first, and of course the stand.
First thing that we will do, we'll put the plane on the stand, like this. We will check the manual. Now, you cannot go wrong. Look at this. It's even, there is a notch here, so just...
You can't even put the wheels wrong.
Yes, you
put it look at
here,
that fit.
And this is for the... floats
later if you will use the floats on this plane.
So now the next thing is we will open the bags, take out the screws. We will see there are some washers inside.
You will put them on.
Yeah, of course.
Use all that you have in the box, in the bag.
No, one washer.
Put the washer on and that's it.
Like this. I have very, very big fingers.
And yeah, now you have the crooked fingers, and that is why Captain Blush is assembling this.
I don't think that I'll put the washers.
Oh, without?
Yes. Like this.
Well, if it doesn't have the big enough hole, then you don't have to use them.
No. What did they say? It's so cold inside. Like this, first. Second one, like this. Use a screwdriver. You just... put them in until you feel...
Yeah, you have to tighten resistance. Them with the feeling. Because they go in the plastic, so don't be too strong here.
Like
enough,
this.
Just enough.
Okay. So...
This is amazing.
Now, well, the next step is the tail...
The tail wheel.
The tail wheel. Now, you get here two smaller screws. I will show you. Those two small screws we will use later for the wing supports.
For the elevator support.
No, these
for
are
the horizontal stabilizer.
Yeah, these are the springs that steer your tail wheel, and these are the two screws that go here.
That you will need here.
Now, just slide this into this notch here, like this. Now, I will use this screwdriver. I'll put one in, like this.
It must be sexy leveled.
Yes, like this. Last one.
Now you will see, viewers, I mean, this is amazing how simple these planes from the E-Flite are to assemble and of course to disassemble later.
Of course. Now, I usually go almost all the way. Now, after I do both, then I will tie them in. This, like this. This is it.
Yeah.
Now, I think that I will now put springs on, which is very easy. You just, there are hooks, you see,
yeah,
on the springs. I'll just put one right here, put another one in like this,
then because this will turn,
yeah, this will turn
the
your
same servo as it turns the rudder, it will turn your wheel.
Yes.
And this is really great solution, we love it, eh? And look at this, eh?
This is usually the way it's done on the big planes, on the balsa planes. This is also works as a damper, so you don't ruin your servo.
Your servo, yeah.
Now,
what will you now put the back, the smaller wings?
Yes, this was my intention. Now, you have already these supports on. I just put on your tail fin,
and it just clicks
like this.
And later, if you want to disassemble it, you push it here. And you will take it out, and you can put now here the screw, huh, Captain
Brock? First, I will put this on. It is just, you know, back in the day when I was starting in this model world, this was the way to go with this. These hooks that just hook on the back. You don't need to screw nothing.
Yeah.
Just put them in. I will put it on the lower one. The lower hole, like this. Now, push that. Yeah, I can't from this side, it's so hard.
Yeah, but turn it to you, but what's with you?
No, like this, it's okay. Like this.
I can't show nothing with yours.
Well,
but you will see.
The end result is this.
You can't go wrong. Look at this. This is it.
Well, it's
and
very hard
it is secured
to film here from this side, this small part. Okay. Now what is this? The elevator is secured. Now I will turn.
But
the
I
plane.
Can see even here the support. Do you see this? The carbon bar even here inside.
Yes.
Look how this is reinforced. I mean, this is something.
I'll turn the plane.
Really, really good quality of the plane.
Because I'm right-handed. Show this.
Yeah, I can come there.
Yeah.
I will come from here.
Now you just put the screw through this little hole.
Well, you do have the magnet. What's with you?
Well, I do have very big fingers. Like this. Screw it in. Do you have a smaller screwdriver, maybe? Uh-huh. Oh, it's going.
Is it?
And yes, that's it. Like this. Yeah. This
you will
done.
Tighten them later when you will put the second one.
No,
just you will just check them later if you need to. Or is it okay?
No, it's okay. Now tilt it this side.
On the other side.
Like this. And then like this.
I turn it to you so you will be easy to assemble it.
Like this.
Alright, this is great.
Now, second one, there is already a carbon bar inside. Now push it in. Like this.
Yeah, push the carbon bar first.
Yes, I will, eh? This was my intention, eh? Like this, like this.
And now put the other one.
The other one, like this. You need to put it in the hole first, eh?
Yeah, it would be good, eh?
Yes! Well,
then
squeeze me.
This, you must be careful of this to put together.
So they, like this.
No! Yeah, but this is amazing, eh?
The elevator is connected. The next thing is I'll put another screw in from this side. As I said, maybe I should even use this, eh? Because I do have big fingers, eh? As you can see.
Hey, don't lose it.
Oh my god, eh? Sometimes I wish I would be smaller than I am, eh? Like this.
Yeah, but that, what would be that? No, Captain Blush. You must be like you are because the camera loves you, eh?
Yes. Well, this is a job.
This is amazing, eh?
Like this, eh? Even with my very big fingers, I was able to put.
Will you put it now from the stand? Oh, uh-huh. You can put the wings on the stand.
Like this.
Yeah. One wing and the second. You can still use the stand for this, of course.
Yeah,
you
at
can
least
put
for
it,
one wing.
You can put it on your wheels, but hey, if we have here the option for the stand, why not? Eh?
Yes. Now I will use these screws that were here.
I think that I will need four of them.
Four of them, and that's it. Eh? This. The other two are for the.
Now, of course, which screw to use, you also have in the instruction manual. It shows to you which one.
Yes.
The carbon bar.
Carbon bar, all the way in. Now, this is the.
And the great thing is.
I will do it rather.
Put
like
the carbon
this.
Bar first in the plane, like we
like
always
this,
do.
Like this.
Like this.
Like this. Now, you don't have to think of anything.
Because
you, just
you have the connectors on, and that's it. I mean, this is so amazing. Hey, I'm impressed here.
Now just push it in, and that's it, there is the
when way. Does it fit so good? And now you can screw the bolts in.
Yes, like this again.
I mean, because you know how many times.
Don't over tighten the screws.
Don't over tighten, but you have seen viewers how they fit perfect. Because many times on many planes you have the assembly like this, and you put the wing in and you have half of the hole missing, eh? Yeah, that can be so frustrating that this is amazing, okay? But, and you tighten and you tighten and you can't do nothing. But you have seen here today that this was a perfect fit all over again, eh?
Yes, like this. Now, this we have one side, and for the other side, I will do what?
Yeah, you can put it, no, like this. You will have to put the screws in.
Yeah, I will. First I will
put it on the back.
So first I will put, I will do it my way.
I did it my way, my friend, the time has come
for you to shut up when I will assemble
to assemble this plane.
No, I will put some screws. No. Get back to the feeling. Now stop singing, you're distracting me.
Hey, do that again. Yeah, this is because you want to do it your way.
Yes.
Perfect fit again.
Yeah, of course. It's E-Flite.
Oh, look how good it looks, viewers, eh? Hey, this maiden flight, I can't wait to do, Captain Blush.
This will be perfect. Now, I think that my job is done.
Yeah, that's it. Because all the control horns were already connected on the wings.
I had to connect only one.
The elevator, the rudder was already in. And of course, at this point, my friends, we still won't put on the prop.
No, I will just tell the viewers where the CG is. CG is 65 millimeters plus minus 5 from the leading edge.
65, so I will go with 67, and that's it for the first time. Or I will go for the first time with the 65 when I will set the CG on this plane.
No, I will.
You can open that for me.
I will open this for you.
And now put the bind plug out.
In. I will put in the bind plug for you.
You will prepare this.
I will prepare it all for you. Where is this?
Because today, this time, I will plug this in a simple AS3X way. That means that this time I won't set the safe select on this video, just the AS3X. So we will set the plane and see how the surfaces are working and of course how the prop will work.
Yes, I will do
that. So we'll test that later.
Prepare this for you.
But later, maybe if I will choose, I will set also the safe select on. But we will see.
Yes. Like this, okay. I have prepared this for you, so you will be able to put it on. Like this, yes.
Yeah, but do you have
the
key?
The key? Not the key.
Uh-huh, I have the keys here.
Put it here. I think it's number 13.
Check.
I think it's number 13 as usual.
Because we have promised viewers that in fact in the future we will show you.
Yes.
Is it 13? Yes.
Number 13.
We will show you also the toolbox that we use.
So this is it?
So this is it. Grab the camera.
Yes, you're next.
I will grab the radio and of course watch for the this.
No. Don't turn it off.
Where's the radio?
I will take the radio, wait.
I will go for the radio and the battery. Oh. And of course, like I said, viewers,
this is sexy, eh? Well, excuse me, well, I was a bit nervous on the assembly because those screws were small, eh?
We are still learning here, viewers, how to film the assembly because...
Maybe I should use a tweezer, but...
Yeah, maybe, but who cares, eh? You have done the perfect job, and obviously with Captain Blush for this.
Yes.
This is it. You have seen that I don't think that it can be more simpler than this to set this plane.
Look, it took me 15 minutes with all the...
Yeah, with all the talking and all.
With all the stiffness, eh?
Of course, and now, I will turn on the radio and I have said that I will engage this plane today with the 4-cell battery. Of course, later, if you will stuck in the 3-cell battery, listen and you will hear if it will count the 3 cells. So you will be certain that it has recognized it. So this is it. Now I will turn the radio on again. We will use the NX6 Spectrum radio again. Now this is still set the Acro. I didn't change the name because this Acro, this was the Twin Otter plane. I have set this plane myself. I didn't use the template in the radio, but of course for this one today, I will use it again. I will just go here. Do you see it?
Yes.
I will go in the system, setup, yes. Model select. Aha, now.
See, it's all over. Add new model.
Add new model, yes, yes, here. Confirm this one, we will go in bind and flight and create, and we will check if we have here the E-Flite Air Tractor. E, carbon Z, check.
Air Tractor.
Air Tractor, this is it. I will select this one, go down. Confirm, import.
Few seconds, wait.
Wait for a few seconds, and that's it. We have the Air Tractor here, all prepared for you. I will just check if it does have, because it is not the smart, so I don't think that again we will have the sound on this or anything. No. We don't have the sound, so I will just bind this and we will see later on which knob is what. We will check and I will show you maybe just quick how to set one voice. You will see where to set the voice on this radio. So this is it. Now today I won't have, I will just tell you this. You must set yourself. Now if you want to bind in the safe select or in just an AS3X, you go back again in the system. System setup and you go down here to the bind mode. Bind. Put the cursor on and wait. Don't bind this just yet. Now, if you want to bind this in the safe select, I have now here the bind plug in, put the battery, wait till the first beep and then remove the bind plug and then bind it with your radio. And that way you will have the safe select on and later you will set the switch for that. But today I will just bind this in old fashioned way. I will just have the AS3X assist on this plane this time, and that means that I will plug the battery in and leave the bind plug, and you will see later. Are you ready?
Yes.
So this time I don't have to worry. I just plug it and I will now bind. And that's it, you have seen it. The bind is complete and it went through the surfaces once. Now that means that this time we only have the AS3X select. Now look at this. And tell me that this is not sexy with these lights.
Yes.
Of course now, I will unplug this, put the bind plug out like this. I will put the cables in where they should be. In the future, I don't need the cables anymore. I just need now the battery plug. And of course, I will plug it in again. So we will see on which knob they have, because the plane is already set in the radio, we will check on which knob is what this time. So this is it, Captain Blush.
Mm-hmm.
I have here, of course, I will put the sound a little more sound. You go back, you press here, this one, the cursor for the back. And you can see here now that this is flashing the volume. I will put to 85%.
Volume 85.
Now we have 85%, and now I will plug this. I will plug the plane.
Yes.
And let's check on what is what. Now wait. So it goes through the plane once. And that's it. Now we will check this, if maybe something need to be trimmed. Now I can see already, do you see this?
What?
I can see the elevator.
Yeah, the elevator is a bit.
The elevator is not good. The rudder is not good. Now I will tell you, since we are filming this, how I will do this. I will just go inside here. Captain Blush, we can do it quick just for the viewers.
Don't do it now.
Yeah, but you can come here and show, but what's with you?
What will you do now?
Yeah, how they can fix this?
Yeah, but you not fixed it now.
Yeah, but not, I will just tell you for the later, mate. Yeah, Captain Blush, but what's with you?
Just unscrew this screw.
The first time, I will just unscrew this screw. I will set manually the surfaces. So...
Okay, do it now, because I can see it in your eyes, eh?
Not in your eyes, but just for once we can show to the viewers. I just do this. Look, I will manually set this. Tell me when it is.
Yeah, now? Yes.
And just screw it back and that's it. And that's it. I have manually set the travel, so it is good. So now I still have the whole trimmer left for me in the radio.
Yeah, as it should be.
Because if I trim the surface in my radio now, maybe later in the air I would have nothing else left for the trimming. So first time when you engage and plug the plane, set your surfaces manually all around the plane, so later you have all that left. Now I will just check if it is okay. And rolls. Uh-huh. Left, right, it works great. Up, down is okay. The rudder works okay. And that's it.
Let's throttle.
The throttle. Usually they put the throttle cut on this.
Yes.
Again. And of course we will check the flaps. Ah. And if you put, I will tell you this. In this radio, particular NX6, you don't have the function to slow down your servos. So if you want to have the slow down servo on the flaps, they already put it for you in the bind and fly settings that you already have in the radio. And that's it, eh? This Perfect. Is it, eh, Captain Blush. Mm-hmm. And like I have said, I will just put one, what? Aha, we can put the, I will put the throttle cut on, put the prop on, so we will see how the prop is working and if the throttle cut is working. Now again, you must tighten this with the feeling. Don't be too strong, because again, I won't put the spinner on, because I will take it down again and I will paint this prop. Don't be too strong, because it is aluminum, mate. So this is it. We will just quickly check the prop. Huh?
Perfect.
So this is it, you have seen this, and I will just tell you quick, I will show you quick, if you want to set yourself the voice on this, so you will hear if you have, I didn't check the double rates, where does it have? They usually put the low rates and the high rates on this knob, which again, later you can put on some other knob if you choose. I will just show you this. When you put yourself the voice on something, you go here to audio events, you go switch changes, add new sound event, switch. I will do this. Switch for the throttle cut. I will go here, choose. Now you just find, go down, down, down. Throttle stick, you will see, you will find. Throttle low, throttle cut off, choose this, go here again, for the second stage of the knob, it was here somewhere, close,
yeah, I think so,
throttle low, throttle cut on, do you see now, switch H, position 0, throttle cut off, position 1, throttle cut on, and listen to this now, if I put the throttle cut.
Throttle cut on. Throttle cut on.
And that's it, eh?
Perfect.
And you can assign to all these knobs, this sound event, and I love it. And of course, at the timer, because that is the most important thing for me, I always set on the timer, I set the timer, so it tells me when it is the last minute, the last 30 seconds, and it's counting even more after I expire the flying time, so I can hear how much I have gone for that time. So this is it, I will turn it to you for the closure of the video. Now this plane, and I can show you this, look, listen.
Mm-hmm.
The AS3X is working. You can see that it's not in the safe because it doesn't want to tilt the plane, but you just have that little assist for the windy days. And this is it, eh?
Perfect.
From the assembly to the setup of the plane, you can do this in what, 15 minutes, eh?
Yes.
If we were not talking, if we were not filming, but it's not the point to do it as fast as possible. The point is that you are having a beautiful time with your plane. And this plane, now with the battery, if I hold it in my hands, I mean, this is something, eh? I mean, look at this, eh? Huh? Now, 1.5 meter, now this is one decent size.
Decent size, yeah. Yes.
And the wings are so easy to disassemble, so you can put this in any car, and of course you will have the perfect first low wing scale plane. So this is it.
Yes.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with beautiful and sexy E-Flite Air Tractor. Your first low wing scale plane, that is just amazing. What else can I say? The assembly is easy, and I can say right now, I know that this plane will fly good. I don't even have to test it to tell you that this will be one sexy flyer. But I will tell you that, of course, once again, you will get for your money what you will pay. But later, if you click or not, but that's up to you, who cares, eh? So this is it. Thanks again for stopping by. I hope that these videos are useful to someone. If they are, do comment, because if you need a videos like this, we will film them also in the future. But if nobody will watch them, who cares? We won't film them anymore. So this is it, Captain Blas.
Yes.
Look at me! Because we must do what?
No.
I think I will put the battery out, turn the radio off, take the prop down, paint it, put it back again, set this plane like it should be, and tomorrow we will see you on the runway again with this. And that will be something. So this is it. Mm-hmm. Thanks again.